Welcome to another project. In this project, we're going to create a loading bar. As you can see from the final version of the project, we have a header here, and also we have a percentage, loading percentage number, and also we have a loading bar. If you refresh the page, we see the numbers is incrementing from 0 to 100. This project is going to be useful for as a preloader for any websites, and you can use it in your own project. We're going to learn how to increment these numbers and change the bars width using JavaScript. So see you in the next section for the HTML part of the project. All right, let's start our project. First, we open the Visual Studio Code. We close the Get Started tab, and here in the File menu, we click on Open Folder. I would like to create the project in my desktop, but you can create it anywhere you like in your computer. So we click on Desktop here, and here we click on the New Folder button to create a new folder. We name the project Loading Bar, and we press Enter. Now we choose the Select folder here, and we close the Get Started tab again. Now we can create our HTML file. So on the left side in the Explorer section, we right click and we click on New File. We name the file index.html and we press Enter. Now on the right side, we have our index.html file, which is completely empty, but we can use an exclamation mark to make an HTML5 boilerplate. So we write an exclamation mark and we click on the first auto suggestion. Now we have our HTML5 boilerplate, which includes a doc type, which tells the browser what version of HTML we are using. For HTML5, we use HTML here. Then we have the HTML tag that covers everything, including the header and the body section. The length attribute inside the heading opening tag defines the language of the page, which is English in our case. Then in head section, we have metadata and title. The charset attribute defines the HTML character encoding, and UTF-8, which covers all the letters and characters, is recommended by HTML5. Then we have the compatibility meta tag, which tells the browser in particular things to the Internet Explorer browser to use the most recent rendering engine, which is Edge. Then we have the viewport meta tag. Let's use Alt-Z to see all the code and turn on the world wrap. The first part of the viewport meta tag tells the browser to adjust the page's width to the device's screen. For example, for the mobile device, the width will be much smaller than a computer screen. Then we have the initial zoom level of the page, which is 100% in our case. Then we have the title, which is the title of the browser, and we can see it inside the browser. Let's open the browser. In order to see the browser inside the Visual Studio Code, we can use the Live Preview extension that we have installed. So we right click and we click on Live Preview, Show Preview tab. Now here on the right side, we can see the browser, which is completely empty, but with the title document. Let's change the title to our project's name, which is Loading Bar. And inside the body tag, let's add a container that covers all the code. A div with a class of container. And we press Enter to accept the auto suggestion. So we get the div with a class of container. Inside the container, let's add a heading tag, just H1, and we just write loading. After that, we have a div with a class of counter, so we just put the number here. So we press Enter, and we just add 0% for the text, which is hard-coded now, but later we are going to change this one dynamically using JavaScript. After that, we have two bars or line breaks. We use HR tag to make a long break. We set the class of the first one, loading bar, back because we want this to be behind the main bar. And we have another HR tag with a class of loading bar front. So later in JavaScript, we position these line breaks to absolute, so they will be on top of each other. And we set the color of the back loading bar to a lighter color so we can see an empty line and the filling line. Yeah, that was it for the HTML part of our project. In the next section, we're going to start styling the project using CSS. So see you in the next section. All right, in the last section, we have finished with the HTML part. In this section, we're going to start styling our project using CSS. So first, we create a CSS file. So on the left side in the Explorer section, we right-click and we click on New File. We name the file style.css and we press Enter. Before starting to style our project using this file, we need to add a link to this file within the HTML code. So we go back to the index.html and just after the title tag, let's first close this so we can see it better. So just after the title tag, we add a link tag. We just write link and we click on the third auto suggestion, the one with the CSS. As you can see, now we have a link tag with the relationship between the HTML file and the external style sheet, which is the style.css. The href attribute defines the destination of the link. And as both files, I mean the index.html and the style.css, are located at the same directory, so we just need to write here style.css. All right, so now we can use our CSS file. We go to the style.css and we start styling the body section. So we just write body, we open a set of curly braces. First, we remove the space around the body section, the default margin. So we just write down margin 0. Then we change the display to flex to be able to bring the items to the center horizontally. So we write justify content center to bring them to the center horizontally, and we can bring them to the center vertically. Just first we have to set the height to be 100% of the viewport height. So it's 100% of the screen size. And we use align item center to bring them to the center vertically. We change the background color to be black. And we change the color of the text to be light gray. And we change the font family. We change the font of the heading and the 0% using font family property. And the font I would like to use is cursive, but you can use any font you like in your project. So we just choose the first auto suggestion. Now we get this beautiful font. Let's next install the main container, which is here, which covers everything. And it has the class of container. So we just need to use the CSS selector dot container. And we open a set of curly brackets or curly braces. Just first we bring the numbers to the middle using text align center. And let's increase the width of the loading bars to, for example, 300 pixels. And that was it for the container part. Then we have, style this class, this div with the class of counter. So just under this, we write dot counter and we open a set of curly braces. First, we change the font size. We just change the size of the number. We just set it to be 40 pixels. I think that's big enough. And next, we're going to style the next HR tag, which has the class of loading bar back. These both have a similar styling, but the difference is we want the color of the bar in the back to be lighter than the bar in the front. So in the standard CSS, just under this, we target the loading bar back first. First, we change the position to be absolute. So we bring the both lines on top of each other. So we just say absolute. And we want this to be absolute in relationship with the container. So in the container, we should change the position to relative. Otherwise, the positioning will be relative to the body, which is the main parent. Then we have, let's change the height to be 8 pixels. Let's change the background color to be light gray. And let's give it some width, just say 100%. Now we can see it clearly. Let's add some border to the bar, just a little bit of border. So we use border radius, 5 pixels. And let's increase the width a little bit more, just make it 400 pixels so we can clearly see the bar. And let's remove the border, the black border, just say border none. So it looks much better. And yeah, that's it for the loading bar back. For the loading bar front, it will be the same styling, but with the different colors. So we just copy this using Alt Shift arrow down. First, we have to highlight it and then use Alt Shift arrow down. And we just change this back to front. And we change the color to be, for example, let's see what color we have here. Just any colors you like. Yeah, just choose the orange red. And this width, if you change it, if you, for example, check the 10%, you can see the bar has 10% orange red color, and the behind bar still is 100%, which has the color of light gray. So later in JavaScript, we're going to use some methods to change the width and the number dynamically when we refresh the page. So let's change this width to 0%, and we're going to change it inside the JavaScript. So in the next section, we are going to add functionality to our project using JavaScript. So see you in the next section. All right, in the last section, we have finished styling our project using CSS. In this section, we are going to add some functionality to the project using JavaScript. First, we need to create the JavaScript file. So we open the Explorer section using Ctrl-Shift-E, or you can open the Explorer from here, Ctrl-Shift-E. So we right-click and we click on New File, and we name the file index.js. Before using JavaScript in our project, we need to add a link to the JavaScript file within the HTML code. So we go back to the index.html file, and just at the end of the body section, we add a script tag. We just write script, or we just write SC, and we click on the second auto suggestion, the one with the SRC. As both files, I mean the index.html and index.js, are located at the same directory, for the SRC section, which is the destination of the link, we just need to write index.js. Now we can use JavaScript in our project. So let's close this Explorer section by just dragging this line to the left. And we go to the index.js file. The elements we need to manipulate is using JavaScript is this percentage number and also this bar, but the front bar. So in the index.html, we have to target this counter class and also this loading bar front class. In order to return an element with a class, we can use the query selector method. So in index.js, we just add a constant. We just name the element counter element. We want to target this. So we equal this to document.query selector, just query selector. We use Alt C to turn on the boot wrap so we can see all the code. And inside a set of parentheses, we need to specify the selector. Because it's a class, we just need to name with a dot at the beginning. So we just write dot counter. The next element we need to return to our JavaScript file is the bar, but the front bar. So the class is loading bar front. So we copy this name. We go back to the index.js and we create a constant. We call it bar element. We just write document.query selector. And inside a set of parentheses and a double quote, we just write dot and we paste the class name. All right. Now we can manipulate them. For example, as you can see here, we can just say counter element dot, for example, inner text. And we just can set it to, for example, 20% instead of 0%. So in order to do so, we just make a function to update it every, like a 1%, 2%, 3%, and the bar as well. So we make a function here. So first we create a variable and we call it index, IDX, and we set it to 0. So we start from 0 and we call a function. We just call the function num, update num, and we create the function just under it. So we just say function update num, and update num. And here we just manipulate our counter element, just change the inner text to, I set it to, as you remember, we did it 20% like this, but I want it to be dynamic, so we keep the percentage, but we add the index at the beginning. So now it's 0% because the IDX is 0. If we change the IDX to 10, we see here that the percentage is 10, or 100, we have 100%. So we return this to 0. And next things we want to manipulate is the bar element. We just write bar element. The things we want to change is the width of the bar. So we need to tap to the style, and then we use the width and we equal this. We can do the same things here as well. For example, we check 10% and we see the 10% red bar, or 20 or 50. So we make this dynamic as well. So we delete this, and outside we just say IDX plus this. And if you change this IDX to 20, for example, we see 20% here and 20% width of bar. Let's return this to 0. And we need to loop this until 100. So we use set timeout method. First, we need to increment the IDX 1 each time the function is called. And we check if the IDX is less than 101, which means until 100, we use set timeout method to call this update num function again. But we just say every 20 milliseconds, so you can see it. So if you refresh our browser again, we can see that the bar is changing at the same time with the counter number, counter value. That was it for our project. That was a very short project. I hope you enjoyed and learned new things. So see you in the next project.